all of you that are graduates of Colorado's finest, how many of you wish you had not come there and gone back to your original high school? That's what I thought. My goal in being here tonight is to honor two people that were a big part of your lives and a part of my lives. Dr. Tom Sinnott. In August of 1986, I walked in the door of Colorado's Finest after being a veteran teacher for more than 12 years. Richard Gould walked in the door the same day, and we started talking. Richard had never taught before. He was 38 years old, had been a cab driver, had been a journalist reporting from Nicaragua, and had also been in jail because he refused to go to Vietnam. I'm a Vietnam veteran. And I have to tell you, I respected Richard more than most veterans that I knew because he had one thing going for him. He paid attention to what was going on around him, and he made a conscious choice not to go to Vietnam. And I respected that so much, and I felt so good to have him as a friend in my life, and he was a friend in my life for the 27 years that I knew him. Richard has some characteristics that I think benefited all of you. How many of you ever saw Richard display an ego? The man had no ego. He never had any anger. What he did have was a love of family, and if you were to meet his wife and his son and his daughter today, you would be to see the reflection of the love that Richard had for his family. Richard Gould was an authentic human being, and I am honored to have known him, and I will carry a part of him with me for the rest of my life. Now, Richard and I had the same experience that August day in 1986. We walked in to Colorado's Finest Alternative, and we were reborn. And the reason we were reborn is because who we met when we walked in the door. We met Dr. Tom Sinnott. Tom Sinnott was an innovator. He was a trusting human being. He was a family man. He was a teacher. He was a learner, a lifelong learner. And the things that he provided, I'm going to list some for you that will help you remember why Colorado's Finest was a good experience for you. First of all, how many of you ever, before you came to Colorado's Finest, were able to walk in, sit down in the principal's office, and say, "What's up, boss?" Never happened. What Tom did, he took the student-teacher relationship and made it into a student-teacher partnership. He put all of you and gave you the responsibility for your own education. And you remember we had a point system? If you got points, that was because you earned them. And if you didn't have points, it was because you had something better to do and you just prolonged your high school education by an hour or two or three or a day. Well, if you can get extra credit. He also organized the school in family units. What was the purpose of that? He gave you guys somebody who every day you could anchor to. There was somebody that touched your life that was part of the staff every single day. and all of you had different family unit leaders, but you all felt that you could approach any teacher because I was not Dr. Wilson, I was Tom. Richard Gould was not Mr. Gould, he was Richard. And that was part of the reason you enjoyed coming to school there. He also provided us all with trust. As a teacher, I could do things and he would support me if I was right or if I was wrong. And if I was wrong, he would go to bat for me with the central administration. And he did that more than once. And he did it for every single teacher that was in there. And as a student, he did it for you too. Now, how many of you, anybody in here ever face appeals? What did that teach you about life? It taught you benevolence. It taught you about respect for the things other people are going through, because you had to sit in front of a jury of your peers, but you also had to sit in judgment of other folks. And I think it's made every single one of you a better person. And we have Tom Sinek to thank for that. Now, here's the thing. Go ahead, that's with the volunteer, Tom Sinek. Here's the proof that he made education about you. When you graduated, you remember there were two ceremonies. There was one when you got your diploma, but more importantly, there was one called the Rose Ceremony. What was the purpose of the Rose Ceremony? You received a rose, and you were supposed to reflect on who was somebody in your life that got you from where you were when you came into school to being a high school graduate. Now, you all presented your roses to somebody. Sometimes you presented it to your family unit leader. Sometimes you presented it to your parent. Sometimes you presented it to your boyfriend or your girlfriend or your child. Sometimes you presented it to Tom Sinek. Sometimes you presented it to the custodian, Mabel. Rock on, Mabel. But anyway, that taught you a lesson about what achievement is all about and how you got to be there. And now you are all alumni of Colorado's Finest. It's my pleasure right now to introduce two people to you. First of all, just to say a brief word, will be Joyce Sinek, Tom's wife.
I just want to say thank you to everyone who attended and knew my husband, and he loved Colorado's Finest. That's why he's in his high school. And he went all over the United States to teach, and he was principal of all these high schools, and the one that he talked about till the day he died was Colorado's Finest Alternative High School.
The lovely young lady next to me now is Tom's middle daughter, Tiffany, and she'd like to express some thoughts.
So my dad had a philosophy when it came to education and teaching. And that philosophy was that each student was like a flower. And the key to teaching and the key to education was to focus on the flower and not the timing of the bloom. Because my dad knew that each of his students were going to bloom. It just depended on what time they decided to bloom. And my dad was so proud of Colorado's Finest. And if he was here tonight, he'd be so happy. He'd be so happy to meet and see each one of you. He knew in his heart that each one of you were going to bloom, and he'd be so proud of the people that you became. As my mom said, his favorite school of all the places that he taught was Colorado's Finest. In fact, my dad was really sick with cancer and couldn't be doing well. The one thing that would cheer him up was to go on Facebook, because he'd have postings from some of you that would talk about how your life changed and how much you meant to him. So I thank you for that. In fact, the day before he died, he got a letter from one of you guys, and it just made him so happy and just made him at so much peace. So as a family, we want to thank you. We
want to thank you for giving our dads one of the best days of their lives. There is a special dedication of my dad at Colorado's Finest, October 23rd. He died October 22nd, and Colorado's Finest on October 23rd will be dedicating a bench in his honor that will be at the school at 3 p.m. We would love for all of you to attend. My dad's Facebook is still up. It's Tom Sennett. There'll be postings about the dedication. You are all invited to be there. Also, there's a yearbook out on the table tonight. We would love for you to sign it. So again, thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Thank you, Tiffany. And I think that a lot of applause and appreciation should go out to Chris Klosterman and to Eva for putting this on tonight.
Let's give it up for Tom Wilson and everybody who came out and choked me up a little bit. That was beautiful. I remember that school. I love that school. I came from damn near dropping out, and I graduated, so here the fuck I am in front of you lovely people. And I think, on that note, we want to celebrate, right? So, is it time for some more rock and roll, or what? I think this is Saturday night in Denver, Colorado. And you know, it's kind of a nice little intimate event. It's all good. It's not a fucking sold out show. But let's see how loud all you lovely people can make this little place sound on the count of three. One, two, three. Let's give it up. Let's keep that shit going.